यासीन प्लीज म्यूट योर माइक। राइट, सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज GANs, जेनरेटिव एडवर्सेरियल नेटवर्क। वी हैव कवर्ड दिस यूनिट फॉर जेनरेटिव मॉडल, RBMs, MCMC, गिब सैम्पलिंग, ग्रेडियंट कंप्यूटेशन एंड डीप बोल्ट्ज़मैन ओवर। लास्ट क्लास वी लर्नड अबाउट वेरिएशनल ऑटो इनकोडर्स। टुडे वी विल लुक एट, नाउ वी आर इन यूनिट 5, टुडे वी लुक एट GANs, जेनरेटिव एडवर्सेरियल नेटवर्क। ओके, व्हाट इज GAN? From the term, you know, you can understand that generative means generation, generating. The same thing we learned in variational autoencoders. What did we learn in that? We were able to generate, samples by going through some probability distribution and applying various equations and then sampling methods. We could generate new data, something which is non-existent. GAN, first part in this, the first term generative is about creating, generating, producing something which is not there earlier. Adversarial. Adversary, have you heard about adversary? Adversary means an enemy. Okay, so what happens in adversarial? Adversarial meaning there is a conflict or opposition. It means adversary is an enemy. Adversarial situation is a situation that is characterized by some conflict. What happens? You say something, okay, you say A, then your adversary, the opposite person, he says something else, okay, A dash, and then here both of them will create a sort of conflict. Okay, so that is this term means adversarial, generative adversarial networks. Networks are neural networks which has got input layer, hidden layers, and so on. Essentially, GAN, generative adversarial network, is about creating. What are you creating? You are creating new images. Okay, it can be faces, new faces. It can be new scenes, sceneries. It can be new images related to trees, for instance. Likewise, you generate new something new. Okay, it's like drawing, okay, music also it can generate. You know, our AI, artificial intelligence, is generating a synthetic music through this GANs, using GANs. That music is not at all generated by humans, rather by GANs, and that music resembles exactly like real music. And you know, AI has become painters or painter also. AI application is doing painting, is creating sketches, portraits. So, and this all because of this GANs, all happening with the help of a technology known as generative adversarial network under deep learning. So it is about creating like drawing a portrait, composing a symphony. These scans are relatively harder because the goal here is to produce something different and something new. Typically, a deep learning model will perform prediction task or classification task. What is prediction? For instance, whether a class will happen or not after this class, or a student will pass his exam or not, or whether rain will occur or not, whether the cricket match is played or not. Like predictions, these are predictions. What is classification? Given a image of a mango tree, whether it is able to correctly classify that it is a mango tree. Or generally in deep learning, what happens is cats and dogs images are there. Whether a system, a model that has been developed is able to identify the image correctly as a dog image or correctly as a cat image. Okay, that is also classification. This is one task, this is another task, but the most toughest task is to generate a new kind of cat image, a new cat image, which is not seen earlier, not seen previously. This is nothing but a generative model. Here, what happens in the prediction and classification? We saw that you have CNN for images, and apparently RNN for text that can classify images or text. Whereas when you talk about GAN is all about generating. Okay. And then what does GAN do? The main focus of GAN is to generate data from scratch, mostly images. But other domains, including music, have been done. Okay. Like music, as I told you, AI application has successfully generated a synthetic music, which is like a real music. And the scope of this is very bigger. If you look at this example, this is a horse image, and GAN is generates a zebra from a horse. This is like a zebra. This is a horse. The training image has got image of a horse. And what the model came up with is, it has come up with a variant of this horse, which is non-existent. This is something new that has been generated. Okay, so this is generated by the model. GANs comprises of two different elements or components. It composes of two deep network. One is known as generator. The other one is known as discriminator. Generator network and discriminator network. these two together combine to form GAN, generative adversarial network. What is generator? Generator, from the name, implies that it creates images. All right. And then okay, a discriminator. Discriminator try to create a fake image. Okay, fake image. And then generator try to create a fake image, and discriminator try to identify whether it is a fake image or a genuine image. It is like this. Here you have original image, original image. Okay, and here you have generator. Generator is the one that will generate a fake image. Generator will generate fake image. And both of this will be given to discriminator. What does discriminator produces? It produces one or zero based on whether it is a fake image or a true image. Okay, this is the architecture of GAN. All right, how this is carried out? How generator will generate a new image? That is done through sampling. Okay, we sample some noise Z. Some noise is sampled using a normal or uniform distribution. Okay, using a probability distribution, noise is sampled. With Z as an input, we use generator G to create an image X such that X is equal to G of Z. This Z is noise that has been sampled through some distribution mechanism. Means when you have this so many data points and you sample means identify a subset of this huge set, that is nothing but sampling. Various techniques exist to sample. For instance, if all Hyderabadi students, okay, you need to sample how many of them are actually doing computer science with electronics, for instance. Then from the set consists of all computer science students, all electronics students, and all students who are doing computer science and electronics. And then using some distribution mechanism, you sample. You choose some students who are doing meeting the criteria. This is sampling, okay? And from this sample, a new image is created, okay? Which is actually the fake image. Look at here, this example. This is a mug, a blue round cup. And this one is a yellow tall cup. If you sample Z using normal distribution between 0 and 1, or Z sampled using uniform distribution between minus 1 and 1, you can generate an image of blue round cup or this yellow tall cup. You look at these images, they look like real images. So conceptually, Z represents the latent features of the images generated. For example, the color and the shape. Latent features are those features that are hidden. Latent means hidden. We learned this latent space when we studied about this encoders, autoencoders. When we studied about autoencoders, variational autoencoders, we learned that there is a latent space. The input is mapped to a latent space, which is in encoded form. Okay, that one. That is latent space, hidden, not directly visible to the user. Okay. In GANs as well, there are latent features of the images. You see here. These are the images. These are the images, and these are the images that are generated by GAN. Images produced in CoGAN. These faces do not exist in reality. These are the images, faces that are generated by GANs. All right. Here, important point is that we cannot control the meaning of Z. Recall that in deep learning classification, we don't control features. The model is learning. We can't control. Okay, what are the features that model is learning? Can you tell me what are the features? If you consider this face, features might be eyes and the size and shape of eyes, nose, and its size and shape, lips, its size, shape, color, brows, its again color, size, shape. Hair, length, size, shape. These are the features of an image. What features are learned by the deep learning model in order to classify or predict something is not known to user. It is beyond the user's control. Likewise, what are the features that are generated and used by GAN is also beyond our control. We cannot control the semantic meaning of Z. And we let the training process to learn it. Training process, that is the use of training, right? Why do you train? You train the model so that the weights are learned. And what are those weights? Weights are the matrices that will identify the features of images. All right. So to discover its meaning, the most effective way is to plot the generated image and examine ourselves. Whatever image has been generated, that image should be plotted. When you plot the image, you can know whether the following images are generated by progressive GANs using noise Z factorial. Okay, these images generated by GAN using Z factorial. Please recall that what is this Z? This Z is for sampling noise. Sampling the noise or having some features that one can be done through normal distribution, through uniform distribution, or another mechanism is factorial. And here, through factorial, images generated are these, and these are not real images. These are absolutely fake images, and no one on the Earth planet exists with this face. Okay, so what is this magic generator of G? Generator is doing magic kind of thing, because it is generating something that is not existing. So how does it? Actually computing. That is given in this. This is DC GAN. Understand this model. What is this model? This is Z, means some values, some numbers which are generated. That is being fed to this convolutional layer 1. This one. This one is taking it and forwarding it to, okay, this is input. This is not convolution one. This is convolution one. This is project, okay, this is reshaping of the input. Look at this. This input is a vector. Vector means one dimension. And observe, this one is not one dimension. This is two dimension. Okay, so here, actually it's three dimension. This here, this one, and this one is, this is one dimension, two dimension, three dimension. This is three dimension. Project and reshape. This input is reshaped to 1024 by 4 by 4. All right, then that reshaped input is feeded into the convolution layer. This convolution layer has got this 512 by 8 by 8. Okay, and there is a stride of 2. And then if you observe here, we are reducing. What are we reducing from 1024 to 512 to 256 to 128? Okay. Then this actually Z a set of numbers. Z is a set of numbers. These numbers are processed by this convolutional layers in such a manner that eventually there is an image generated based on these values of Z. G of Z. So the following is the DC GAN. DC GAN means deep convolutional generative adversarial network, which is one of the most popular design for the generator network. This network is one of the popular design. What is this network? This input, projecting and reshaping, convolutional layer 1, convolutional layer 2, convolutional layer 3, convolutional layer 4, and finally the excuse me students for a minute. All right, sorry about that. So we are learning this architecture. This architecture is generator. Generator will just create a random noise. The discriminator in GAN provides guidance to the generator on what images to create. Okay, and consider GAN's application, cycle GAN. There is another kind of architecture known as cycle GAN that uses a generator to convert real scenery into a Monet style painting. This is a real scenery. The cycle GAN will convert the scenery into a painting. Okay, so by training with the real images and generated images, GAN builds a discriminator to learn what features make images real. What are the features that make images real and what are the features that make images fake? All right, please give me a minute. Okay, sorry about that. So here we are, by training with the real images and generated images. Okay, there are some real images there are generated images. Real images are the actual images which are being supplied to the network for learning purpose. And generated images are those images which are produced from that noise. Okay, and then what GAN does is it builds a discriminator, and this discriminator learns what features make images real. It means when can we say that image is real and when can we say that image is a fake or generated one? What are the parameters? What is the process that is learned by the discriminator? This discriminator learns how it should classify between these two types of images, and then it provides the feedback. It provides the feedback to the generator. This is generator, these are real data set. And because it provides the feedback to the generator can learn to create images which are similar to the real images. Okay, here diagram is given. Input generator. Generator will generate an image, give to discriminator. Discriminator also gets training samples, which are the actual images. And then discriminator will learn what is real. Okay, and gives that feedback to generator. And this generator understands that. The discriminator is able to identify that image is not real, so then I should make the image to look like a real image by updating it, by changing its parameters, by doing some kind of, you know, automatic feature engineering. That is this figure illustrates that point. How discriminator provides the feedback to the generator and how generator learns from that feedback and improves. How it is done technically, that it discriminator looks at real images and generated images separately. It distinguishes whether the input image to the discriminator is real or generated. And the output D of X is the probability that the input X is real. That is P of class of input equal to real image. Okay, here through this Z, a generator has generated an image. Image is fed to the discriminator. This discriminator gives the output D of X, and discriminator is trained just like a deep network classifier. If the input is real, we want D of X to be 1. Okay, this should give a value 1 if image is real, 0 if image is generated. The output, and if it is generated, it should be 0. Through this process, the discriminator identifies features that contribute to real images. On the other hand, we want generator to create images with d of x equal to 1. Okay, what the generator want? Generator want that it, whatever image it has created, that image output should be given as 1. Okay, why? Because this generator would like to have a output 1 for the generated image. When a discriminator say that the output is 1 for the generated image, it means that generator has created a real-like image. the generator has succeeded. Okay, and then it matches the real image. So then we can train the generator by back propagation to target this value all the way back to the generator. We train the generator to create images that words what the discriminator thinks is a real. It wants to fool this discriminator. And it wants the output to be 1 for its generated image. We train both networks in alternating steps and locks them into a fierce competition to improve themselves. They have to, this discriminator wants to improve itself and want to actually classify the image as real or generated perfectly. This generator goal is to get a value output 1 for its generated image. So they both are, against each other. That's why it is adversarial. Adversarial means there is an opposition here. There is a conflict. What's the conflict? Here, this wants 1 for real images, but here this one wants 1 for fake or generated images as well. And eventually the discriminator identifies the tiny difference between the real and the generated image, and the generator creates images that the discriminator cannot tell the difference. Okay, the GAN model eventually converges and produces natural look images. All this process yields a image that looks like a real image. This discriminator concept can be applied to many existing deep learning applications because the discriminator in GAN acts as a critic. Okay, what does critic do? Critic will say if it is good, it says good, if it is bad, it says bad. We can plug the discriminator into existing deep learning solutions to provide feedback. Okay, so this input generator images, what this GAN does is input generator image discriminator. This discriminator gets generated image and training samples and it yields an output. Okay. The how this training process is done, we'll look at tomorrow, back propagation. Okay, bye-bye.